Good morning and welcome to our devotion. This morning we will read from Habakkuk chapter 3. I'm not going to read the whole chapter, but the last few verses that we all know very well. Though the fig tree does not bud, and there are no grapes on the vines, though the olive crop fails and the fields produce no food, though there are no sheep in the sheepfold and no cattle in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in God my Saviour. The Sovereign Lord is my strength. He makes my feet like the feet of a deer. He enables me to tread on the heights. Beloved, when the Bible speaks of our joy, we discover that it is the Christian's response to all the blessings we have from God. But the wellspring, the fountain of joy, is our salvation in Jesus Christ. For example, James instructs us to count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds. Count it all joy when you meet trials of various kinds. But we cannot be joyful in our trials apart from our salvation in Christ. In Psalm 119, the psalmist says that he delights in the word, in God's word, in God's commands, and in God's testimonies. But we cannot find joy in God's revelation without being in Christ. And at the end of Luke's gospel, just after Jesus' ascension, we read that his disciples worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. But we cannot worship joyfully apart from being in Christ. Habakkuk was a prophet during very difficult days. In this short Old Testament book of Habakkuk, the prophet raises complaints to God about the sorry state of the affairs of Judah. Habakkuk is burdened because God seems to be indifferent to the appalling spiritual condition of his people. You can go and read that in Habakkuk 1, verses 2 through 4. But after God answers his complaints, Habakkuk responds with those beautiful words, "I will take joy in the God of my salvation." This morning, is that your joy? Is it your joy that God sent his only begotten Son to save you? Is it your joy that he is the God of your salvation? Maybe the more important question, do you take joy in him? Let us pray that the Holy Spirit would impress on you his great love for you, because that is what everything is about. So great is the Father's love that he gave Jesus to be your salvation. Let us pray that your joy would be evident and recognized by others, your joy in Christ being your Savior. Let us pray together. Our Heavenly Father, what a privilege to know you as our God and our Lord, to be able to call you our Heavenly Father. What a privilege to know that we may find our joy in you. This morning, Holy Spirit, we would like to pray that you impress on us the Father's great love for us, so that we live from the knowledge that the Father gave his only begotten Son for my salvation. Lead us in a joyful life. And lead us, Lord, that our joy would be evident and recognized by others as the joy that only the children of God possesses. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us now in song give thanks with a grateful heart. For tomorrow morning, our scripture will be from Romans chapter 5, Romans chapter 5, verses 1 through 11, and we will continue with the next fruit of the Spirit. May you have a blessed day until 6:30 tomorrow morning.